today we are at the COTC conference, which is a NATO conference where we explore technology and discuss different ideas throughout the industry. This project here is using, in this case, two different robotic platforms, and we control them by putting an EEG cap on somebody's head, and they think commands to the robot, and the robot does them in real time.
The way the technology works is there's a screen in front of the patient, and the screen will show flashing lights over a series of commands. And by concentrating on the command visually without moving or anything, we're able to use an EEG cap to pick up brain waves that are correlated to what signal they're concentrating on. And this allows someone who can't move to control a robot.
This can be ported to different types of robots. So for example, we have Now, and he has the ability to communicate. So for example, if someone doesn't have the ability to speak on their own, then they could think and the robot could talk for them.
I see you want me to grab a red object.
Very smart.
We have been developing many different methods, algorithms, and techniques to basically drive this robot to do different things, including recognizing the expression on the face and things like that.
We also have the ability to drive a kind of rover, similar to the Mars rover, around using only brain signals as well. This has many applications, including you don't have to go into a dangerous zone by yourself if you have the ability to, say, control a robot and have that go into that zone for you.
That attracted their attention because they could actually see the use of this in many different applications that are relevant to their needs.
Since logistics is one of the five syndicate topics of this conference, it was crystal clear for me to invite the Old Dominion University. And in addition, it's very important for us military guys to listen to non-typical defense players around the globe, and academia is one of them.
We have been doing this kind of demo at least once or twice a month to outside people. Whenever a student comes in the lab, the first thing that I do with him or her is really tag them with the existing students and let them to see and basically learn from them exactly how it is done. So the very first batch, I actually had to teach them, but since then, they're actually teaching themselves.
I am absolutely ecstatic to be here and be part of this project. It's very exciting, and it also feels like it does have so many different applications that can be helpful to so many people, that it feels like you're working on something, you know, and really making a difference.